Lutz now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. He'll look to throw, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ball game. To throw. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. So there's one big play followed by the timeout as we're under 10 seconds to go. And now how do you play it offensively? We'll find out. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Throw. He completes it to Julio Jones, and they will get the timeout. So 3 seconds remaining, and they can trot out the field goal unit and try to send this one to overtime. So on fourth down, off goes Matt Ryan, and on is another Matt Bryan, and a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So on fourth down, off goes Matt Ryan, and on is another Matt Bryan. With 3 seconds to go, if it's good, we're off to overtime. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And that will tie things at 17-all. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. Set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. The slot man in motion right. Time running out here on the play clock. A 20th carry now for Freeman. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped yet turn it into something big on a later carry. I'd stay with him.
Hey, let's go. Get up.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Here's Ryan. Room to run past midfield. Getting it out left side to Sanu. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Freeman. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35. Second down, 9 yards to go. Gabriel, the man in motion. On second down, Ryan. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Ryan finding Gabriel for the Falcon first down. A lot of efficiency here on this drive. Heck, this may be their best drive of the game.
Yeah, if they'd moved it like this throughout the entire game, we probably wouldn't be here in overtime. But right now, what you just said was the key word, efficiency. Taking care of the ball, move it downfield, get themselves in a position to score and win this game.
And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
So now it's first and goal. Gabriel, the man in motion. After the penalty, here's Freeman. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Time a factor as Ryan will hustle him to the line. They've had some success here in overtime with this opening drive running the football. Right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think they're.
And he is in for the score! Absolute stunned silence here.